Why don't you talk to some of the people in the camp? Find out why they're here, what they're fighting for. Then come tell me if you've learned anything.
Okay. Any people in particular? I should speak to others in camp to learn of their experiences in times of war. Warden Two-Edge wants me to talk to some of the people in camp and learn what they think of war. When I'm done, I can find Two-Edge by the command tents and tell her what I've learned.
Ah, the sun smiles on thee.
Did you need something, young one?
Oh, we talked to some people already. Does that count? Tread carefully. We live in dangerous times.
Did you need something, young one?
I've been talking to people around the camp, as you suggested. You've not been gone long. Come speak to me after you try talking to a few more people. Okay.
For Waterdeep.
Two of my family members joined the crusade. If I face them in battle, I don't know what I'll do.
We'll show the crusade, right?
Good morning to you, ma'am. I mean, who do we really talk to? Soldiers?
You're rather outlandish folk to be wandering round here.
Thank you. Oh, here's the, we've come full circle, literally. So we should talk to some more Water Davians and...
Light's too bright. Can't we camp during the day?
No.
The City of Splendors is my home.
What is it?
Troubled times are upon us.
I don't see why the City of Splendors is involved with this. Let the Flaming Fist handle it, I say.
For Waterdeep.
Good day, and hello to you.
Once you're on the battlefield, you'll see some real fighting.
Still we wait.
This waiting is tedious. While we sit, Kalar grows ever stronger. Maybe it's named people we need to talk to? Maybe... would Jeg have anything to say? No. Well, we got a messenger. Hold on. You have a message for me?
Still we wait.
Oh. No, you don't. What's in here? I don't think I should be picking that. Alright, let's go in here, maybe. In here.
What?
Can we find some people?
You gutless worm, what gives you the right to tell me what to do with my men?
Uh-oh. General Stonehand saying that to somebody?
You mean your 50 men? Why, my 350 men, of course.
Oh, look, it's John de Lancie.
A tenth of Daggerford's population, de Lancie. 1 in 10. That's what I've brought to this effort.
That's what we need to win this battle. The power of the queue.
And it is appreciated. But Baldur's Gate, and especially Waterdeep, have provided the majority of troops here. I'll not risk them needlessly.
Can I be of any assistance here?
And who, pray tell, are you?
My name is Rumpelstiltskin.
General Hather Stonehand, Torsin Cedric de Lancie, allow me to present the hero of Baldur's Gate.
Oh, aye. So what was that business on Boroskir Bridge about? You know how many of our people worship Lathander? Tempest? And you burn the dead lord of bloody murder Baal symbol into the ground where he died.
Hey now.
Right, that's sure to boost morale.
I did not myself do that.
Hather, please, show a little decorum. The reinforcements you've brought are a welcome and much needed asset. Your presence is problematic. Many are disturbed by tales of Boroskir Bridge. It would be best if you were away from the camp for a time.
I like the third option, but... yeah, you would send me from here on account of some coward's whining? What kind of commander are you?
A highly successful one.
Until now.
Everyone has a part to play here. The hero vanquished Saravak. If they can do the same to Kalar, it's to everyone's advantage.
Yes. All about the vanquishing.
If we've any hope of defeating the crusade, troop morale must be maintained. Your presence works against that.
Deal with it.
As it happens, there's a matter that requires attention a ways from here. Word has gotten round that Kalar's forces are receiving supplies via caverns beneath Dragonspear Castle. We have a rough idea where the entrance is, beyond Dead Man's Pass, as the locals like to call it.
That's assuming the information we have is accurate. Torture usually gets you answers, but it doesn't always get you the truth.
Torture? Tell me this isn't true. Are we so afraid of Kalar Argent, or are our principles truly so weak that we stoop to such vile deeds?
I'd stoop lower than that if it meant saving the life of a single soldier under my command.
Does this sort of talk make anyone else uncomfortable? Because my skin is crawling right now. Judge me if you must, Sapphire, but for the Sword Coast's sake, do it after the Shining Lady's been dealt with. Fine, let's pretend we haven't flung ourselves on the moral high ground and be about our business then.
We have reason to believe Kalar Argent's top advisor, a priest named Heffernan, is quartered in Dragonspear's basement. We know very little of Heffernan, other than he apparently has Kalar's ear.
We do know that a series of caverns runs beneath the castle. We believe Kalar is channeling supplies through the tunnels rather than attempting to break our perimeter. So there is a way into the castle from below.
You want me to use the caverns beneath Dragonspear Castle, our enemy's stronghold, to break into the castle, again, the stronghold of our enemy, to try and gather intelligence about this Heffernan?
That is what needs doing. Will you do it?
I'd be lying if I told you I wasn't unsettled, knowing how you came by your intelligence. But the Shining Lady is the greater danger. She must be dealt with. I will do as you ask. Good. We'll be about your business then.
Just so we're clear, our resources are limited, and our focus must be on containing the castle. If you should get into trouble outside this camp, you'll be on your own. We simply don't have the personnel for a rescue party, no matter how valuable the person captured may be.
Oh yeah, so valuable enough to torture the hell out of people, but not to rescue them. Got it.
Before you leave, there's a tent near the camp entrance that belongs to a dwarf named Fossy Dugdeep. Go see her. She's been working on something you might find useful as you explore the underground river beneath Dragonspear.
Does sound pretty interesting, actually. Alright, well, I'm supposed to talk to people about war. And I doubt this rat knows much, so what do you have to say, Warder Davian, Warder Mage?
Good day, and hello to you.
Torsin de Lancie knows what he's doing. He'll push Kalar's rabble back to Dragonspear and snuff them out for good. These people all are leaving. General Stonehand. General Stonehand.
I shall. Well, look who we have here. The hero of Baldur's Gate deigns to walk among us. Aren't you supposed to be spelunking in Kalar's caverns?
I thought he was one of the... I thought it was de Lancie and Stonehand who were talking. Oh. Nederlok is the other one. I am But before I go, tell me, what's your impression of Torsin de Lancie and Marshal Nederlok?
Nederlok's good people. Won't say a word against him. De Lancie? Oh, that's another story.
Tell me your tale, General Stonehand.
He's a coward. I hate to say it, but there it is. We should have taken Dragonspear when we first arrived. Red-blooding Kaelor was out in the High Moor then, doing God's know what. The castle would have fallen faster than a house of cards.
He prevented you from taking the castle?
Well, he's had us twiddling our thumbs for weeks. First, he wants to thoroughly reconnoiter the castle. Then, wait for further troops. Then, the hero of Baldur's Gate has to be here before we can do anything. Now, he wants to hold till you finish your business in the caverns.
Hmm. I'll conclude that business as quickly as possible. Then Torsin de Lancie and I will have a frank discussion about our overall strategy.
As you say. I'll leave you to your business then. Watch your back.
Thank you.
Under normal circumstances, I would never say this, but I could use some help.
What's wrong, Safana?
In the last couple of days, I dipped my fingers into a few pockets. One held a bag of junk and this notebook. It contains details of the camp defenses, commander names, and bits of conversation.
Huh. Well, this is a surprise.
Only a spy would make these kind of notes. We have a traitor in our midst.
Where did you take the notebook from?
That's the problem. While I was working, I wasn't paying attention to faces. It could have come from a few different people.
What were the other items in the bag?
There was the notebook, of course. A potion, a candle, and this sheet of paper covered in runes of some sort.
What kind of potion?
Do I look like an alchemist to you? It might be a healing potion, but it's in a weird bottle. Maybe the traitor purchased it in camp. There was the notebook, of course. A potion,
candle.
It's not your average tallow stick. Gold leaf is pressed into the side, and it's quite heavy. There's nothing else special about it. Maybe a priest could tell us more.
And these runes?
There was the notebook, of course. It looks like the page was torn out of a book. I can make no sense of the runes.
No sign of the book it might have come from, though?
All I know is it came from someone's pocket. There was the note. It looks like the page was torn out of a book. I can make no sense of the runes.
Those look like military code to me. Maybe one of the higher-ranking officers in camp knows something about it.
All I know is it came from someone's pocket.
Can you tell me nothing of the people you robbed, Safana?
Robbed is such a loaded term. I prefer to think of it as easing friends' physical burden. As to the question, they were all soldiers, I think.
All right, let's ask around and try to figure out the traitor's identity.
Don't let me down.
You don't let me down.
Well, look who we have here. The hero of Baldur's Gate. Now that you mention it, I do have a bug in my boot about something. I've heard rumors of a thieves' guild forming in camp. Small at the moment. I'd like to make it smaller still.
What makes you think a guild is forming?
You always get some leeches in camps, but this one's had more than its share. Some of my men say they've been asked to steal from dead soldiers and pawn their scavengings through a black market. Mm. I won't have that sort of business going on here.
Wow.
The guild will pressure the soldiers to do what they ask and make an example of those who won't. Not an uncommon practice.
You're new here, so the guild... You may be a black heart. Can you take care of this?
Alright, sorry if that was chopped up. How shall I track these thieves down?
Start with a merchant named Wyzob. I've heard she'd sell the corpus right off your granny's dead eyes.
Wow, well, that's how you say that name. Okay. And if I do take care of your problem, what's in it for me?
I may be a dwarf, but I'm no skinflint. How does 500 gold pieces sound? Start with a merchant named Wizob.
Alright.
Well, don't go announcing your mission to the whole camp. Keep it under your hood, eh? Now, get moving.
Bossy. I should talk to people around camp and ask about the candle, potion bottle, and page of runes. The traitor. Safana came to me after picking some pockets around camp. One of her victims was carrying a notebook filled with sensitive information, meaning we might have a spy in camp. I need to investigate and find out who the traitor is. All I have to go on is the other items Safana stole. One item is a potion bottle with an unusual shape. It might have been purchased in camp. Another item is a heavy candle with a gold leaf design on it. It looks like it might have religious significance. The last item is a page of unusual runes. And then Den of Thieves. General Stonehand, head of the Daggerford forces, asked me to uncover the growing Thieves Guild in camp. I should start by questioning a potential fence, a gnome named Wizob. We know that, how to say that name.
You're out of your bloody mind, Pritchard. Keep this up and you'll be out of bloody teeth, too.
And there's a lot going on at this camp. Pritchard says if we move now, we can take Kalar's people by surprise.
You don't know that, and even if you did, it's not your decision to make. Just let it go, Pritchard.
Sorry, guys.
Like it or not, we aren't the ones who get to make the call.
Oh, there, Stonehand. What's going on here?
Pritchard here thinks we should send a small force into Dragonspear to try and take out Kalar and end this mess before the real battle gets underway. As I explained to him, we aren't operating independently here. The camp commanders have to agree on that sort of action.
And you think they won't agree?
Nederlok might go for it. Delancie, though? He's happy enough to try and starve Kalar out. Anything to avoid bloodshed. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got to go talk to a hole in the ground about me peeing in it.
Pritchard is apparently making a nuisance of himself. General Stonehand of the Daggerford Militia is extremely permissive when it comes to criticism from her underlings. But I suspect her patience is beginning to wear thin when it comes to a gnome named Pritchard. Interesting how all this is under Glint Gardnerson's. Yo, Pritchard. Actually.
Sword first!
I've had it, Senpek. I've had it. Just let it go, Damius. It's not worth it. I tell you, if the gnome says one more word to me, one word, it'll be the last one he ever utters again. Alright, I'll need to go talk to them next. Sergeant.
We're few, but fierce.
The Flaming Fist reinforcements have arrived, yet still we stand around doing nothing. What's that pompous twit Delancie thinking?
We've been discussing important strategic matters. What do you want?
Nothing that cannot wait for another time, I think. Forgive me the intrusion. If you'd nothing to contribute, be gone. I've no time to waste on frivolous conversation.
A pleasure it is to meet you.
Camp food gives me terrible indigestion, but I still can't get enough of it. Alright, we got a lot of people we need to talk to. I still don't know who we talk to about war.
War is almost here.
Yeah. Once we've crushed this crusade, we can all go home. I mean, maybe just talking to these people is enough? They're not really specifically talking about war, though. I mean, not...
War is almost here.
They're saying it's almost here, but it's not the actual text that's coming out. Here's... Sempec and Damius might be the thieves we're looking for.
We're few, but fierce.
Good morning to you. I am Sempec of the Daggerford Militia. This is Damius. Join us. Have a drink. Sounds good to me. Damius says, so listen, you look like you've seen your share of violence, and you're still alive and in reasonably good shape by the looks of you, so I'm guessing you're pretty good at the whole killing of others thing, am I right? Why do you ask? There's a gnome in our contingent. We're from Daggerford, named Gardnerson. You mean Glint? What? No, his name's Pritchard. Pompous jackass. He thinks he's better than the rest of us. He thinks he's in command here. Well, second in command after General Stonehand. He needs to be taught a lesson, and I'm thinking you might be the woman to do it. What do you say? Interested? I might be. I mean, we can't just kill him right there in front of everybody. I came upon a crusader a couple days ago who was carrying some interesting potions, one of fire giant strength, the other of fortitude. I was saving them for the final assault on Dragonspear, but I'll gladly part with them if it gets Gardnerson out of my hair. You plot to murder one of your own and expect me to help you? No. No, I'll not countenance such a thing. Not now, not ever. I don't need fire giant strength and fortitude. I'm sorry to hear that. Not as sorry as you're gonna be, though. Die! Okay. Apparently one of... It'd be best if I sort him out sooner or later. Well, I know exactly where he is, okay.
Trouble?
Yeah, say that.
Hear me!
Alright.
Trouble.
A bit.
What is it?
Break out the magic missiles.
And?
Aye.
Oh, chunks.
Yes.
What?
Hurry.
I hear. Sweetheart?
Yep.
Well, there's a fire giant strength and her fortitude. This Pritchard? Who are you?
In
Pritchard!
What the hells is going on here?
Pritchard Gardnerson, I presume?
Gardnerson, son. Explain yourself. Why have you killed my men?
They plotted to kill you. What? I don't believe it. I understand why you wouldn't want to. Nonetheless, I speak the truth. Or nevertheless, rather. If you don't believe me, take it up with the Flaming Fist. I am here at the behest of the Grand Dukes of Baldur's Gate. I'll be doing that. Just you see if I don't. I should speak with Glint about what to do with his cousin, Pritchard Gardnerson, son. Perhaps his cousin Glint will be able to help me decide. Pritchard will no longer interfere with the attempt to thwart. Really, he won't? I don't think that was supposed to show up. I think that was supposed to show up if I killed him. Alright. Hmm? Alright, so where's the medium healing? Yeah.
Speak.
You want Boo? Sword first!
Got a foggy
war
out here.
War is almost here.
For Baldur's Gate.
Pardon me, I didn't see you there.
War is almost here.
If I find that thief, he'll feel Tempest's wrath. Oh, this is Marshal Nederlok. What'd he say? She's about yay tall, brown hair, whining loudly, if I understand things correctly. You haven't seen her? What are you talking about?
Good to see you.
You as well, Marshal Nederlok.
Hold a minute. I know you're in a hurry, but I have something important to ask you.
Okay.
You know the daughter of Grand Duke Silvershield journeyed with the Flaming Fist from Baldur's Gate, yes? Do you know where I might find her?
Ski? She was with us when we arrived at the camp. This much I know. What happened to her after that, I couldn't say.
Whatever it was, I bet she complained about it.
I gather she's not endeared herself to you, or much of anyone in your troop. If you see her, tell her to seek me out, please. It was one thing to torment her on the journey here, but if she were killed or fell into enemy hands, Duke Silvershield would be displeased.
I hope he would be a little more displeased, at least.
Yes, that would be awful. For the Crusaders, better they endure her wailing than we do.
I'll leave you to your business now. Thanks. I should look out for Ski Silvershield. I still think it should be pronounced Sky. Should be with the Coalition forces here in camp, but Marshal Nederlok is having trouble finding her. I hope she isn't in any trouble. At least no more than usual.
Good to see you.
I mean, what if he's the traitor? So, I don't know. Mizana. Who am I looking for? I'm looking for that one with the crazy name I can't think of. Not Voglin, but...
Speak! How can the Lion of Luskan be of service to you at this time?
Wazab, that's right. Further up here.
Soon to go back to the grotto, I am. I miss the tunnels of home.
I heard you were a fence for the camp's thieves guild. I'm afraid you've been misinformed, my lady. I can tell you've never been properly cursed before. I've no patience for your games. I need to meet with someone from the Thieves Guild. Set it up or things will get very unpleasant for you. I'll take my chances. Now get gone. I should follow Wazab to the north and a Wazab to the north end of camp. Steam's General Stonehand was right. There is a burgeoning Thieves Guild in camp. How such a thing could spring up so quickly, I don't know. I tried to get information out of the guild's fence, Wazab, but she quickly saw through me. She headed to the north of camp now. Perhaps I should follow her. Following. Hey.
The underground seems safer by far, and gems to find are welcome too.
I'm not saying much. Are you a thief? Are you from
Excellent
next day for whatever you're after.
Hey, yourself. I'm looking for something out of the ordinary. You wanted to meet with me. Here I am. I know you're part of this would-be thieves' guild trying to make a profit off of war. Disband at once or pay the price. You've got adamantine nerves, I'll give you that much. I could have a dozen hidden thieves with poison crossbows just waiting in the shadows. Well, there are some shadows here, but I don't think enough to conceal them. You'd better use those thieves to our benefit. I'm the hero of Baldur's Gate, and you know I could have your operation and you executed in a heartbeat. No more thieving, and when the time for war comes, I'd better see you on the front lines. Alright, alright. I thought we'd keep our activities quiet, but not quiet enough, it seems. I'll have my people come to the Coalition's side when the battle breaks. Good enough? Good enough, for now. See you when the arrows start flying.
Your acquaintance I am glad to have made.
Okay. Alright, so we finished that. We need to go find General Stonehand about this. There's just so many people here. Oh, here's Glint. I should take to Helvdar. We need to talk to people about war, and I don't know if we've been doing that.
Oh, who goes there? Sorry. A little drink yesterday evening turned into a...
Am I glad to see you? I know we've had our differences, but I need your help. Ski Silvershield's left the camp.
Bench Duncan. Do you know where she went?
Perimeter guard said she headed in the direction of Dragonspear Castle.
And they just let her go?
As far as they know, she's just another fist.
I'll get her back. She was headed towards this Dragonspear, you say?
So the guards say. Bring her back safely. And try not to attract attention. If word gets out about this, well, I'd rather word not get out about this. Now go, quickly.
Yes, that should do it. What? Oh, I didn't see you there. Well, I did. Obviously I did. I'm talking to you. I must have. But it took me a while. Sorry. What were we talking about?
Right, so I was walking up to talk to him before this guy interfered, or interrupted, rather. I'm supposed to ask him about... the other gardeners and son. I really can't remember. I need to track Ski down around Dragonspear Castle. I should speak with Glint on what to do about his cousin, Pritchard Gardnerson's son. Option didn't come up. And Ski? Ski Silvershell has fled the Coalition siege camp. I must find her before she falls into enemy hands. She was last seen headed towards Dragonspear Castle. Glint, I need to talk to you about Pritchard.
Yes, that should do it. What?
Oh, okay. Whatever,
I didn't
then.
See you there. Well, I did. Obviously I did. I'm talking to you. I must have.
And you're certain it's stable?
Am I certain it's stable? Am I certain it's stable? I'm certain.
I prefer the bright of day. Evil must be able to see the justice I dispense.
That's different. Trying to see that Fosse Dogdeep. I'm certain. Pretty certain. I mean, they're stable and then they're stable, you know? What's going on here?
Ah, glad you came. This is Fosse Dogdeep.
Get to know ya. You told me to find Dogdeep, and I have. Now, what do you want?
The same as you, I imagine.
victory over the Shining Lady, minimizing our forces' losses as we achieve it. Your arrival and impending departure for the caverns beneath Dragonspear give us some new options in that regard. Fossey, tell them about the Barrel of Potion of Explosion.
The Barrel of Potion of Explosion?